Ang chulum bria, banto kai damnakar nite vithi savanakar. Tam kal vithi savanakar ne thangai ni.
President, the chamber continues its hearing.
La chambre va reprendre cette audience.
Schedule today, actually, the chamber
pour aujourd'hui
will commence hearing the testimony of a witness concerning Trapean Tmo Dam website. Ms. Sekobute, please report the attendance of the parties and other individuals at today's proceedings. Greffier, Mr. President, for today's proceedings, the chamber. The greffier notes that all parties to this case are present. Mr. Nunchi is present in the holding cell downstairs as he waives his right to be present in the courtroom. His waiver has been delivered to the greffier.
La requête en ce sens a été remise au greffier.
We also received information from Visu that the witness who is scheduled to testify today, that is 2TCW845 and 876, which is a reserve witness, cannot appear today. However, we also have another reserve witness. That is 2TCW881, who is present in the court. President, thank you. The chamber now decides on the request by Nunchir. The chamber has received a waiver from the accused Nunchir, dated 10 August 2015, which notes that due to his health, namely headache, backache, and that he cannot sit and concentrate for long, and in order to effectively participate in future hearings, he requests to waive his right to participate in and be present at the 10 August 2015 hearing. Having seen the medical report of Nunchi by the duty doctor for the accused at the ECCC, dated 10 August 2015, who notes that Nunchi has back pain when he sits for long and recommends that the chamber grant him his request so that he can follow the proceedings remotely from the holding cell downstairs. Based on the above information and pursuant to Rule 81.5 of the ECCC internal rules, the chamber grants Nunchi his request to follow today's proceedings remotely from the holding cell downstairs via and audiovisual means. The AV unit personnel are instructed to link the proceedings to the room downstairs so that Nunchi can follow it remotely. That applies for the whole day. As scheduled, the chamber shall hear testimony of a witness through TCW845 concerning the Trapean Tmo Dam work site. However, due to the witness health, he cannot appear today, and the reserve witness, that is 2TCW876, has some urgent issues who can also not appear before us. The chamber will hear testimony of another witness, that is 2TCW881, this afternoon, commencing from 1:30 p.m. The chamber notes the lead co-lawyer's request to make submissions based on information contained in the co-prosecutor's submission concerning the disclosure of case 003 and 004 civil party applications. They submit that this new information may affect their choice of civil parties to appear to present statements of how harm suffered regarding work sites. The Chamber will therefore provide the parties with an opportunity to provide brief submissions of 10 minutes. However, the Chamber first makes several observations. First, the relevance of the admission of civil party applications in cases 003 and 004 to the choice of civil parties who will present suffering on work site is limited, as only civil parties in case 002 can be heard during these hearings. Case 003 and 004 civil party applicants who are not party to case 002 cannot appear. Second, the Chamber has already indicated to the parties that it would consider recent applications to recall witnesses or civil parties based upon new facts, such as those contained in disclosures from cases 003 and 004. This would also include case 003 and 004 civil party applications in appropriate circumstances. Considering these factors, the Chamber now invites the parties to make submissions on the issue of disclosure of case 003 and 004 applications in this case, and hands the floor to the political lawyers for civil parties regarding their submission. You may proceed.
Merci, Monsieur le Président.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Bonjour à tous.
Good morning to all of you.
J'aurais simplement une courte requête sur la base de l'email qui a été envoyé à la Chambre et aux parties vendredi en fin de matinée.
At the end of the morning.
À titre liminaire, je souhaitais dire un mot sur la raison pour laquelle nous avons envoyé un courriel et pour laquelle nous n'avons pas effectué une requête par écrit que nous aurions pu traduire en deux langues. C'est bien évidemment le caractère d'urgence qui nous a poussé à demander à la Chambre de tenir un débat aujourd'hui pour que nous puissions débattre contradictoirement de la question.
Hearing
nous
on
avons
this
reçu
issue.
We received des informations importantes du bureau des coprocureurs
from the co-prosecutor's
jeudi
office, Thursday
ces informations
this
ont un impact direct sur la liste des parties civiles que nous avions préparée pour communication officielle à la Chambre et aux parties vendredi. Il nous était matériellement impossible de rédiger et de faire traduire une requête dans la journée de vendredi, raison pour laquelle nous avons envoyé un courriel à la Chambre demandant à titre principal qu'un débat public ait lieu sur cette question et à titre subsidiaire que autorisation nous soit donnée de différer le document que nous allions transmettre à la Chambre. N'ayant pas obtenu de réponse dans le temps imparti, nous avons décidé de soumettre notre liste de parties civiles vendredi avant 3 heures, qui était le temps requis pour que le document soit dûment enregistré par le greffe. Mais nous avons précisé dans ce document que nous souhaitions avoir la possibilité de réviser la liste des parties civiles qui étaient annexées à ce document à l'aune de l'étude des constitutions de partis civils qui sont mentionnées par le bureau des coprocureurs dans leur requête de jeudi. Ce que nous demandons est très simple, nous demandons la faculté de réviser la liste qui a été envoyée vendredi à la Chambre et nous souhaitons un délai de 2 semaines. Et je vais expliquer pourquoi nous demandons ce délai de 2 semaines. Nous avons reçu l'information par le bureau des coprocureurs qu'environ 200-250 constitutions de parties civiles relatives à Trappes-Entma seraient mises à la disposition des parties, semble-t-il, cette semaine.
This week, apparently.
Il nous est pour l'instant matériellement impossible de savoir Quels sont les documents au sein de ces 250 et quelques documents qui concernent les parties civiles qui sont également parties civiles dans le dossier
2?
Nous n'avons pour l'instant matériellement aucune possibilité de savoir si dans ces 250 et quelques constitutions de parties civiles qui seront mises à la disposition des parties cette semaine, il y a des documents qui concernent directement les trois parties civiles que nous avions sélectionnées sur Trappe et Antma pour témoigner lors de l'audience sur l'impact des crimes. Donc il nous faut simplement un minimum de temps pour prendre connaissance de ces documents à partir du moment où ils seront accessibles pour vérifier petit un qu'aucun des documents divulgués ne concerne les trois parties civiles que nous avions présélectionnées et plus généralement quels sont les documents divulgués qui concernent directement les parties civiles admises dans le dossier 2 pour le segment de Trappe et Antma. Donc nous avons déposé notre liste, mais nous souhaitons que la Chambre nous donne la possibilité d'amender, le cas échéant, cette liste d'ici deux semaines. La conséquence pratique de cette requête pourrait être que l'audience sur l'impact des crimes soit repoussée. Il appartiendrait à la Chambre de décider ce qui paraît le plus approprié, soit décaler dans le temps les deux jours consacrés à l'audience sur l'impact des crimes commis dans les sites de travail, barrage du 1er janvier, aéroport de Pampanchnang et Trappe et Antma. Vous pourriez fort bien décaler dans le temps ces deux jours, ou vous pourriez décider d'entendre les parties civiles relatives au barrage du 1er janvier et à l'aéroport, et décaler, le cas échéant dans le temps, l'audition des parties civiles qui viendraient témoigner sur le préjudice subi en lien avec les crimes de Trappe et Antma. Nous souhaitons également informer la Chambre que cette communication massive de constitution de parties civiles aura nécessairement aussi un impact sur le choix que nous ferons quant aux documents qui seront présentés lors de l'audience sur les documents clés. Pourquoi ? Parce que la Chamber le sait et les parties le savent pertinemment, nous avons depuis le début du procès 2 fait le choix de présenter des documents, constitution de parties civiles, formulaires d'information des victimes, lors de ces audiences publiques, et qu'il nous faut dès lors vérifier que dans les 250 et quelques documents qui vont être communiqués, il n'y a pas des documents qui sont directement pertinents pour les parties civiles du dossier 2. Enfin, la dernière requête que nous faisons, que nous adressons à la Chambre, mais qui est en fait dirigée vers le bureau des coprocureurs, nous souhaiterions être éclairés, et nous apparaît qu'il s'agit là de l'intérêt de toutes les parties d'être éclairés sur la façon dont le bureau des coprocureurs entend communiquer le reste des constitutions de parties civiles des dossiers 3 et 4. Donc les questions que nous avons en suspens sont les suivantes. Le bureau des coprocureurs entend-il communiquer d'autres constitutions de parties civiles des dossiers 3 et 4? Deuxième question, concernant quel segment? Et troisième question, à quelle fréquence pourrions-nous avoir des informations sur le séquençage des communications de constitution de parties civiles pour nous aider à anticiper tout le travail de vérification que nous devons faire, nous, la section des co-avocats principaux, les avocats des parties civiles, et bien évidemment, in fine, avec les parties civiles elles-mêmes. Voilà donc le sens de notre requête, avoir un délai de deux semaines pour déposer une annexe actualisée des parties civiles qui seraient entendues sur le préjudice subi sur les sites de travail, demander à la Chambre de prendre en compte la divulgation des constitutions de parties civiles lorsqu'elle nous donnera le délai dans lequel nous devrons identifier les documents clés sur le segment, sur les sites de travail, et enfin, enjoindre le bureau des coprocureurs à nous donner les informations nécessaires pour que nous puissions planifier le travail de la section de la manière la plus efficace possible. Je vous remercie, Monsieur le Président.
President, the National Litigant Lawyer for Civil Parties, you may proceed.
Vous avez la parole, le co-avocat pour les parties civiles nationales.
Good morning, Mr. President, and
Monsieur
your honors.
Président, bonjour,
I'd like to add my observation on this matter regarding the new disclosures. Litco lawyers for civil parties and lawyers for civil parties actually do not wish to choose all those civil party applicants from case 003 and 004 to present and to make their statements of harm. What we want to know from the co-prosecutors concerning the disclosure of those civil party applications is that whether the information from those civil party applications from cases 03 and 04, who may also be case 002 applicants, and if there is the case, then it may impact on our selection of those civil parties to provide their statements of hands. And that is the main gist of our submission. For that reason, it is imperative for us representing the civil parties to review those documents thoroughly before we make our choice in selecting them to present their statements of harm. Thank you. President, thank you. The chamber now hands the floor to the co-prosecutor, and you may proceed.
Good morning, Mr. President, Council, civil parties. Your Honour, the prosecution doesn't object to the civil parties making an amendment to their victim impact list in relation to Trepang to my dam. One caveat to that would be that at least that list be made available a number of days prior to those civil parties arriving in the courtroom, so that if there's a change in any of the civil parties, that the prosecution can.
Interruption du président.
President, Mr. Deputy Co-Prosecutor, please hold on as we have some technical issue with the interpretation system.
Avec le système d'interprétation.
Sum chung luk prinya banto.
President, the co-prosecutor, you may now resume le président. Your 10-minute session.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Le procureur.
So, just briefly,
merci, président.
The prosecution don't object to the application
très brièvement, les procureurs
by the lead co-lawyers to amend their civil parties for the victim impact hearing in relation to Trepang to My Dam. But we would say in relation to their application for a delay that, as your honours have said, these applications are civil party applications from civil parties in case 3 and 4, and unless they have an application also in case 2, they wouldn't be civil parties that would be appearing.
Ce ne serait pas des parties civiles qui comparaîtraient en
but I think it is important that they get an opportunity to see whether or not the current civil parties listed
in
fact do have an application also in 3 and 4
s'il y a un lien to take that into account.
But our submission would be that really wouldn't take that long. We would just be simply looking at the list of names when that material is provided. In relation to the application for an adjournment of the key document hearing, we would submit that application would only be relevant to the Trepang Tamar Dam segment of that document hearing.
And
perhaps it is reasonable if they need a few extra days to review those civil party applications that will be disclosed to see whether they in fact would like to present some of those at the document hearing.
Si certains
des
documents sont présentés lors de l'audience.
Your Honours, we would just,
en résumé,
when you decide on this, we would certainly ask that you keep your schedule in relation to Kamanchanang Airport site impact and document hearing. Keep your schedule for the 1st of January dam impact and document hearing.
And keep your schedule for the impact hearing pour l'audience sur
the civil party application in relation to Trepang to My Dam. But in relation to the document hearings, we would have no objection if you wanted to defer that in relation to Trepang to My Dam to a later date.
Or even just the lead co-lawyer's
component of that hearing.
Ou du moins repousser la partie,
and the reason why we say this is the prosecution has said in this case before that it's important that the victim impact hearings and the document hearing in relation to a particular segment are as close as they can to each other. And I think the main reason being is that the parties, Your Honours, and the public can be dealing with one focused set of facts at a time, which would obviously assist in that assimilation process of understanding the complete or the totality of the evidence in relation to that particular segment. So we would have preferred that the impact and the document hearing follow each particular segment, that we understand that Your Honours have grouped them together after the three work sites. But in order to keep the focus on the evidence, we would certainly ask that you not change the schedule for Camp Bonchanan Airport, nor 1st of January Dam,
and
we would ask you to keep the schedule for the victim impact hearings in relation to Trang Pamar Dam,
but we would have no objection to the d'objection à ce que
document hearing
l'audience sur les documents
in relation to the civil parties for Trepang to My Dam
pour les parties civiles relatifs à Trepang to My Dam week or two. D'une semaine ou deux.
And no objection to the amendment
nous ne nous
of the
list
civil party victim impact list for Trepang to My Dam if the civil parties believe
si
that's necessary.
Le bureau des parties civiles le juge nécessaire.
Your Honours, I noticed that
Messieurs les juges,
tried to keep the discussion this morning as focused as possible.
Je sais que l'on veut garder ce débat très ciblé.
On the 27th of July,
le 27 juillet dernier,
Senior Prosecutor Mr. Lisak talked about the prosecutor's disclosure obligations
des obligations en matière de communication,
and the importance of them, the importance to provide exculpatory material,
de fournir des preuves
the importance to provide material that might mitigate
ainsi que des informations
or
des
show
documents
the innocence
qui
of the accused,
montrerait soit l'innocence des accusés
material
ou atténuer les circonstances,
des cast out on the credibility of the evidence.
Qui pourrait
well
jouer
aware
sur la crédibilité des preuves. Nous sommes au courant
Your Honor
de nos obligations.
Has reminded us of that obligation.
Égard, vous nous l'avez rappelé.
And I can inform the court that the prosecution are taking this whole issue of disclosure as a top priority. These cases are large cases. They inevitably involve thousands and thousands of pages of documents. The key, of course, is to find the right pages on behalf of the defense, the prosecution, to address. But all parties should have the opportunity to be able to review that evidence. When parties say it's difficult, it's complicated
lorsque
to do these cases
because
there's thousands of pages to consider.
Travail, car il faut considérer des milliers,
unfortunately,
des milliers
that's the nature
de documents,
of
mais c'est malheureusement la nature
crimes against humanity.
Et des crimes contre l'humanité.
They are massive violations
il s'agit
against
de violations en masse.
A large population across a whole country. These are not simple cases, they're not easy cases.
Ce ne sont pas des
at the other tribunals, disclosure is a central issue
et la communication of making sure est aussi importante
that
dans
the
les autres tribunaux pour s'assurer
making sure
équitable.
The defense have access
que
to
la
the material
ait accès à tous
and
les
they have an opportunity to
besoin,
present that material if they so wish
les documents, s'ils le souhaitent,
and they have an opportunity to challenge it
et aussi de contester.
And we concur with Your Honor's approach certainly in
nous
the
en accord avec l'approche retenue par la Chambre.
Principle that you put forward at the beginning of this hearing that if new material,
si
new civil party applications brings up some
par
evidence
exemple,
that is useful for the defense or is useful for
preuves,
the prosecution
utiles, tant pour les
and it hasn't been available
et que ce n'était
prior,
pas disponible auparavant,
then Your Honours would consider the opportunity of being able to call those witnesses
de faire
so that the defense and prosecution can properly present their cases.
Les
and similarly, we agree
débat.
With Your Honor's position about
et
the parties, the defense, the prosecution,
chambre,
civil parties being allowed to recall witnesses if, for example, new information comes
si
forward that throws a different light on testimony that was put forward and no real opportunity was available to be able to pose
une incidence sur
a certain number of questions.
Et
so,
on cherche réponse à de nouvelles questions.
With this case, and I read the transcript of
j'ai lu
Monday the 27th of July and read the accounts
du,
of the defense
and
prosecution and Your Honours.
Les positions
and perhaps one further thing I'd like to say is that Your Honours are well aware that there are two concurrent ongoing investigations in 3 and 4 that will continue and we've been given indications that they will continue and conclude in 2016. As we speak now, investigators are collecting evidence in relation to these cases and some of that evidence
dans le cadre de ces instructions et certaines de ces preuves qui ont
and so, until the end of this trial,
un chevauchement avec l'affaire
it is highly likely and it's absolutely certain that a certain percentage of that information the prosecution is under an obligation to disclose
devra être communiqué
whether
par
it's inculpatory exculpatory affects the credibility
charges,
of the
des informations qui portent sur la crédibilité
of the evidence. The prosecution at the end of this case does not want to be in a position where the defense have said
they've buried information, they've hidden information,
and they haven't disclosed information. And rightly so, all relevant information should be available to all parties to make what they want with it as they will. The fact that it's frustrating to continually get documents, and documents will come through to next year, is part of the prosecution of large international crimes, and that's what we've all been trained to do in this courtroom. Your Honours, we have been asked to provide a broader approach by the civil parties as to what's coming when. Perhaps if I take it down to the most immediate point, the civil party applications and their summary translations in relation to Trapang Tamar Dam have been filed with the court this afternoon, and the applications and the summaries will be made available by latest Wednesday to the defence. The next question you might ask, well, why now? Why not last week or the week before, when the other civil party applications were put forward? And the answer to that is, Your Honours, those applications were a result of full translations. And it was a priority that the prosecution deal with written records of interview as a top priority, as a second priority, deal with civil party applications that have full translations, and now we've had the opportunity to deal with civil party applications with summary translations, and on the basis of that, that material is being provided. To conclude, I would say that all of the civil party applications that we believe have a relevance to this case would be made available to the defence, the civil parties, Your Honours, within about 2.5 weeks, but perhaps even less, because it requires the authority of the investigative judge. But certainly, what recent practice has shown, the investigative judges have been have become a lot quicker to make this information available because they understand the importance of having this information in well before this trial ends, so people can have an opportunity to object, challenge, or bring it forward. And as Mr. Lysak said on the last occasion, this disclosure on today, which will be available Wednesday, relates to Trapang Tamar Dam and a few statements in relation to the CHAM, is not an 87-4 application. It's a discharging of the prosecution's obligation to make sure Your Honours have the best evidence, to make sure the defence have any exculpatory material or any material that affects the credibility of the evidence. What affects credibility of the evidence is a very complex question. Someone said they work 14 hours a day, someone said they work 13 hours a day. Does that affect the credibility of the prosecution evidence? It's very, very difficult to determine that. As a result, the prosecution wants to err on the safe side to make sure there's disclosure available. If it was ever interpreted at a later time, that the prosecution held on to material that affected the credibility of the evidence before the chamber. We do not want to be in a position to that. We want the defence to have access to everything. What they do with it is a question for them, but they should have that available to them. My 10 minutes is up. I believe I can give Your Honours details as to the nature of those civil party application disclosures that are referred to in this notice. I can give you the numbers in relation to Case File 4 and Case File 3, but you may think it's better to perhaps to do that in a short filing where those numbers can be provided. But certainly, we will have all of the material available in the next couple of weeks, and Trapang Tamar Dam will be available on Wednesday.
Les documents relatifs à Trapang Tamar seront disponibles d'ici à mercredi.
Thank you. We'll hand over to Judge Jean-Marc Lavange.
Le juge Jean-Marc Lavange.
Oui, merci, Monsieur le Président. Monsieur le procureur, peut-être quelques questions pour essayer de bien comprendre ce que vous venez de dire. Vous avez indiqué que toutes les demandes de constitution de partie civile qui ont une certaine pertinence au regard des segments que nous avons déjà examinés, notamment le TRAPEMA, que nous allons examiner prochainement, seront rendues disponibles d'ici deux semaines et demie. Est-ce que pour autant vous pouvez nous dire si, lorsque vous parlez des constitutions de partie civile qui sont rendues disponibles, si parmi ces constitutions de partie civile seulement une partie feront l'objet d'une demande afin d'être versée au dossier? Est-ce que vous avez déjà pu déterminer le nombre de constitutions de partie civile que vous entendez demander avoir versé au dossier comme nouvel élément de preuve? Il y a bien effectivement deux choses. Vous avez une obligation de rendre disponible à l'égard de toutes les parties tous les éléments de preuve pertinents, mais vous, en tant que procureur, pouvez lui demander avoir versé au débat qu'une
that be filed only a small part of a subset.
Donc ça, c'est la première question. La deuxième question concernera plutôt les co-locats principaux. Si j'ai bien compris, les co-locats principaux aujourd'hui ne font qu'une seule demande, qui est de pouvoir réviser la liste des parties civiles qu'ils entendent voir comparaître à l'audience pour être entendus sur l'impact des crimes, et notamment des crimes commis sur le site de Trapinkma, et demande donc pour cela un délai de deux semaines. Ce que je comprends comme signifiant une date limite pour le dépôt d'une liste révisée fixée au 24 août. Je sais que les dates peuvent changer, mais il me semble qu'au jour d'aujourd'hui, les audiences prévues pour l'audition des parties civiles sur l'impact des crimes est fixée au 2 et 3 septembre, ce qui, me semble-t-il, laisse un temps suffisant pour que tout un chacun puisse être préparé. Est-ce que j'ai bien compris ce qu'il en est?
Oui, parfaitement, Monsieur le juge. Laverne, vous avez compris. Nous n'avons pas été informés, en tout cas je parle sous le contrôle des autres parties, mais cette date des 2 ou 3 septembre ne nous a pas encore été communiquée pour l'instant. Donc je n'avais pas cette date en tête, raison pour laquelle j'ai été beaucoup plus générale dans notre demande. Oui, si nous avons deux semaines, il semble que la liste puisse être révisée d'ici le 24 août et que cela laisse suffisamment de temps, me semble-t-il, mais sous réserve des observations de la défense. Cela laisserait suffisamment de temps aux parties pour pouvoir étudier les documents en relation avec les parties civiles de cette liste révisée. Je précise à titre supplémentaire, en lien avec la première observation que vous avez adressée au bureau des coprocureurs, que les autres parties ont la possibilité de déposer des requêtes au titre de l'article 87.4 et que, bien évidemment, nous pourrions avoir un intérêt, nous aussi, à déposer une requête au titre de l'article 87.4 pour certains documents qui sont actuellement en train d'être communiqués par le bureau des coprocureurs.
Disclosed by the prosecutors.
Yes, Mr. Prosecutor, you may proceed.
Le procureur a la parole.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Merci, Président.
Your Honor, Judge Laverne, in answer to your question.
Pour répondre à votre question, Monsieur le Juge Laverne.
Yes, in relation to the notice that the prosecution filed.
Déposé par le bureau des
and that's E319/27, and that was on the 6th of August, which the purpose of that notice was to outline our approach to civil party applications particularly. And our approach has been revised in significant part On the basis of what we heard, counsel for Kusampan and Nuanchia stated on the Monday, the 27th. And the import of that, those statements seem to be that if unless civil party applications were being put forward in relation to Rule 87.4, unless they were being put forward as evidence, I assume that unless they were viewed to be exculpatory on our part or undermine the credibility of the evidence, that the defence didn't really want to read them or use them because enough was enough, too much information. Again, that's the nature, relates to the nature of these trials. And so to try and deal with that, to try and not overburden the defence, if that's how it's viewed, the new procedure that the prosecution are adopting now, other than for the Trepang Tamar Dam one, which will be filed today, but we will provide a revised list as to dividing up the disclosure to those documents which we are likely to put forward to the court as 87.4 and those documents which we are unlikely. So the ones that the defence see on our list that we are unlikely to put forward, then it's really up to them, of course, whether they want to read those documents or not. And so, in the past, what we've been doing is disclosing the documents to the court with no indication of whether or not 87.4 is likely or not on any particular document. And so, the idea was to try and reduce the burden on the defence by saying, of these 50 documents or whatever number of documents in relation to this segment, we're only putting forward, we're only likely to put forward these 10 or these 5 or whatever the number be, a smaller percentage of what you're receiving. And then the defence would not need to concentrate on them if that was the case. And so that's the procedure that we're putting in place now. The only thing in relation to Trepang Tamar Dam is that that distinction hasn't been made in the filing today because of the speed in which we wanted to get these documents to the defence. But what we will do and what we can do is by the end of the week, we could make an estimation and we could make a filing to the court saying, of those that were disclosed, we envisage these 10% or 20% would be 87.4 applications, whatever it would be. But certainly, with all of the other disclosures that that will be happening in the next couple of weeks, we will be making that distinction based on what we heard the defence say. And one final point, Your Honour, in relation to 87.4, in relation to those applications before the court, which is quite different to the disclosure obligation, counsel for Kusampan said, look, they would need more time to be able to determine whether they would object to those documents or not. And we would certainly have no objection to the Kusampan team or the Nuanchia team asking for extra time beyond what the rules normally allow, that 10 or 15-day period, in order for them to properly assess the material. If they wanted 3 weeks or a month in light of the busy schedule of the trial, we wouldn't object to that. And we think that's a reasonable request. Thank you.
The President. Next, I hand over the floor to the defense team for Nuanchia. Counsel Coupe, you may proceed.
Thank you, Mr. President. Good morning, Your Honours. Good morning, Counsel. I've been listening with interest to both the prosecution and the civil party lawyers, but I'm not sure if I follow everything to a maximum. We were here just to remind everybody in this courtroom 2 weeks ago, having, I think, a similar discussion.
Deux semaines, nous avions tenu un débat
then similar. At that time, we were being confronted with having to read disclosure of about 50 civil party applications and witness statements,
enfin, nous avait communiqué quelques 50 déclarations de témoins et qu'on demande de constitution
de partie civile. To the decision to postpone hearing the witnesses.
Pousser la chambre à reporter l'audience du témoin d'une semaine.
Not the first two witnesses, but then during that, the testimony of these two first witnesses, a new discussion came up.
Pendant la déposition de ces deux autres témoins, nous avons
une discussion sur
les documents de DC CAN,
Khmer,
dont une grande partie ne sont disponibles qu'en Khmer et n'est pas en anglais ni en français.
Now we are being confronted
à présent,
with,
nous faisons maintenant face
200 civil party applications,
quelques demandes de constitution de partis civils additionnels.
Of which now I understand it is not certain that they were all, that they will all be put as evidence before the chamber. But of course, at the end of the day, that doesn't change the fact that we have to read them. Not only in terms of evaluating the evidence as such, but also to see if any these civil party applications might have any relevance
si ces demandes de constitution de partie civile pourraient avoir quelque
the witnesses who are appearing this week and next week and the week after
in relation to the suivante et la suivante.
And of course, in your earlier decision, when you didn't postpone the first two witnesses, you said, well, there's always a possibility that witnesses can be called back
if there's a
reasoned request for this. But I don't think in practice that is going to be a workable situation, because sometimes it's only a very small excerpt from a particular witness statement or a particular civil party application that you would like to put forward to a witness. So we are now in a situation that there is possible or likely relevant material out there waiting for us
qu'il y a peut-être
to be reviewed, possibly only as of Wednesday.
But
at the same time, this afternoon, we're starting with another witness from the dam.
Nous allons entendre un témoin sur le barrage cet après-midi.
So I'm not quite sure if I see the difference in the discussion that we had 2 weeks ago, other than now there's a possibility that these documents might not be put forward as proper evidence in the sense of Rule 87. But still we have a situation that we, of course, would like to have the possibility to review these documents to see if they might have any relevance in respect of the upcoming witnesses of this week and next week. So having said this, the question is whether we should continue with hearing witnesses in relation to the dam.
Sur le barrage.
Or whether we have raised this question earlier, whether we simply shouldn't put on hold
nous déjà dit,
any witnesses in relation to the dam being questioned
now,
and simply wait for case 3 and 4 to finish and revisit the dam,
enfin, les instructions
know, maybe sometime end of this year or the beginning of next year,
and la fin de cette année move ou on. Début de
to the next segment
being
the treatment
au
of the CHAM
segment, le
in relation to which witnesses have now been selected and
les témoins ont déjà été choisis
we have been notified of which witnesses are coming.
Notifiés,
so the question I think is a more general issue. Should we continue with
donc,
this very difficult situation of continuous, continuous stream of new evidence? And should we not simply freeze
qui sont
this segment, move on to the next segment and continue with the dam once case 3 and 4, the investigation of case 3 and 4 are finished?
La fin des
so I think this is a legitimate question that should be raised, otherwise we'll unanswered, otherwise we'll be continuing having this discussion
in
the next 2 or 3 weeks. So I think this is at this stage, Mr. President, what I would like to
voilà, Monsieur le Président,
say.
Ce
thank
que
you.
Je voulais dire.
Somos con
President, thank you, Counselor. And now I'd like to hand the floor to the Defense Counsel for Kyuson Pon, and you may proceed, the Counsel proceed.
Merci, Monsieur le Président.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Bonjour à tous.
Good morning to all of you.
Je dois dire que nous sommes devant une discussion qui va même au-delà des échanges que nous avons eus jusqu'à présent et qui pose vraiment un problème de procédure en ce qui concerne l'intérêt et l'objectif des communications. Pour commencer dans l'ordre, d'abord réponse à aux confrères des parties civiles sur leur demande de délai et la possibilité de réviser la liste des parties civiles qu'ils entendent présenter pour ce segment. Il va de soi que nous sommes dans la position de les comprendre et de savoir quel impact peuvent avoir des communications importantes sur la préparation du travail. Il va de soi que nous ne pouvons pas nous opposer à cette demande et que nous en rapportons à la sagesse de la Chambre sur le comment, le délai et la manière dont réajuster le programme suite à cette demande. Ça, c'est un premier point. Deuxième point, les obligations de divulgation telles que formulées aujourd'hui par le coprocureur Bill Smith appellent des observations qui, je pense, devront se faire plus longuement par écrit et un peu plus précisément, mais peut-être une précision parce que j'entends que l'on dit de notre côté de la barre que nous sommes dans un procès complexe, nous le savons, que nous sommes dans un procès où il y a de nombreux documents, bien sûr que nous le savons. Là où nous avons peut-être une vision différente des choses, c'est quelles sont les conséquences de divulgation en cours de procès d'une masse de documents. Il ne s'agit pas de contester et de dire que la défense a des problèmes à lire des documents. Il s'agit de savoir comment on organise notre travail. Il va de soi que lorsque nous sommes en audience sur un segment, que nous sommes dans le cadre de la préparation de témoins sur un segment, devoir en même temps assimiler, analyser et savoir ce qui est censé être utile pour la défense de nos clients. Pour ce même segment, on demande du temps. On ne peut pas être à la fois, je vais prendre une expression française, au four et au moulin. Ça, c'est un premier point. Le deuxième point est de dire que je constate qu'il y a peut-être une évolution sur la position de l'accusation, puisque je me souviens de l'audience à laquelle faisait référence M. Smith, et au cours de laquelle son collègue Dale Lysak nous expliquait qu'en fait, il y avait un certain nombre de communications, mais qui en fait ne changeaient pas grand-chose à la donne. Donc ça, encore une fois, c'est quelque chose que l'accusation peut peut-être dire facilement parce qu'elle a connaissance des documents dans le cadre de son travail dans les procès 003 et 004, mais que la défense et vraisemblablement également les parties civiles ont une autre position puisqu'ils n'ont pas accès à ces documents jusqu'au moment où on leur communique. Donc là aussi, c'est la demande du temps, du travail, un travail qui est différent du côté des parties civiles et du côté de la défense, mais un travail au demeurant qui, encore une fois, va au-delà de la simple lecture de documents, mais qui va à l'analyse de la preuve et à l'impact que cela peut avoir sur des stratégies de défense ou de représentation de clients. Donc ça, c'est le deuxième point. Ensuite, le troisième point, et encore une fois, je pense que c'est un point sur lequel il va falloir vraiment revenir, parce que dans la jurisprudence internationale jusqu'à présent, il n'y a pas de problème sur les témoins qui sont appelés à déposer dans le procès ou qui ont déjà déposé dans le procès pour lesquels il est évident que tout document en relation avec ces témoins doivent être divulgués, c'est important. Il y a évidemment les points sur tout ce qui peut être à décharge vis-à-vis des accusés. Il va de soi qu'il est important pour la défense et les autres parties d'en avoir connaissance. Maintenant, le troisième point, qui est quand même plus délicat et qui est vraiment une nouveauté du côté de l'accusation, encore une fois, en termes de jurisprudence internationale, c'est que dans le cadre d'une procédure, nous avons une instruction, et c'est ce que je disais à l'audience de la dernière fois, où il y a une instruction qui est en cours. Ce n'est pas les coprocureurs qui font leur enquête comme dans le cadre d'une procédure accusatoire, il y a un juge d'instruction avec des équipes de défense qui, encore une fois, peuvent faire des demandes d'actes qui ont une prise sur une procédure à laquelle nous n'avons aucune prise. C'est-à-dire que on vous demande, et on sera peut-être en mesure de vous demander des 87.4 sur tel ou tel témoin qui n'aura pas comparu auparavant dans le cadre de l'instruction 02 du procès 002. Et nous serons dans la situation où nous n'avons pas de prise sur ce témoin-là parce qu'il fait partie de notre procédure à l'instruction. Donc ça, c'est un point, encore une fois, où je sais que nous serons à revisiter la question, mais sur l'incidence que ces communications ont sur le travail de préparation de toutes les équipes, évidemment que c'est un élément important et c'est un élément qu'on ne peut pas traiter comme ça à la va-vite parce que, encore une fois, ce sont des éléments qui sont susceptibles d'avoir une incidence dans la manière dont on prépare les témoins en cours. S'il y a des questions que l'on pose en fonction des nouveaux documents qui sont communiqués, on ne peut pas les poser si on ne les a pas. On ne peut pas les poser si on n'a pas eu le temps de les traiter. Il faut savoir que nous avons des moyens humains limités, que les journées ne sont que 24 heures et qu'à un moment, il y a des choses qui ne sont pas humainement gérables pour faire un travail correct. Donc, c'était les observations que je voulais faire sur ce sujet. Encore une fois, je pense que sur la manière et le type de communication, il y a procéduralement un vrai débat à avoir sur l'impact que ces communications et que celles qui sont annoncées du côté de l'accusation. Pour l'instant, j'entends qu'il y a 200 documents qui vont parvenir. Je ne les ai pas encore, donc je ne peux même pas vous donner une vision de ce que ça peut avoir comme impact sur la défense de que s'entend. Il est clair que ça aura un impact, puisque qui dit document dit traitement et travail du côté de la défense. Je m'en arrêterai là de mes observations, mais s'il devait y avoir un remaniement, comme l'a suggéré mon confrère de l'équipe du Nunchia, là encore, nous fonctionnons toujours à flux tendu au sein de nos équipes de défense. Nous devons nous réadapter et réadapter la charge de travail et la répartition de travail au niveau de l'équipe et il conviendrait que la Chambre prenne en compte ces nécessités d'adaptation. Nous essayons de faire preuve de souplesse, mais pas au détriment de la défense de notre client.
But of course, not at the detriment of the defense of our client.
President, Deputy Co-Prosecutor, you may proceed.
Co-procureur adjoint, vous avez la parole.
Mr. President, I understand that you want to keep the hearing brief, so I will be brief. Just a couple of responses. In relation to Counsel for Nunchia's request, perhaps, or to think about at least freezing Trepang Tamar Dam segment until the end of cases 3 and 4. The problem with that approach, Your Honours, if you actually started to freeze every segment and not hear it until every last piece of information comes in on case file 3 and 4, what will inevitably mean is that this case will be postponed for the next at least 1 year. We are receiving 3 to 5, certainly under 10 statements every week from the co-investigating judges. This will continue right through to next year. We have to have a solution that gives these accused an expeditious trial, not delay it for a year, but also a fair trial that allows the defense to propose witnesses, put evidence forward based on new information that becomes available. I just don't think that's a workable solution. It's an ideal solution, but it's not workable. And just in relation to Counsel for Q Sampan's points, I think one thing's clear is that the defence, the prosecution, the civil parties, and if I can say, I think the judges, understand that the prosecution has an obligation to disclose a wide array of material.
We have no choice in that. What Your Honours does with it, what the defence does with it, what we do with it, what the civil parties do with it, that's really another question, but we have an obligation to disclose. This is going to keep happening throughout this period. What I would propose is that there be a more workable, perhaps, meeting, maybe with the senior legal officers, about the timing and the approach to get down the lag times between requesting for authority to disclose from the OCIJ to getting that to the defence, and what's a solution that the defence can be involved in so we don't continually debate every week or every 2 weeks. Once this civil party applications have been disclosed, once these ones have been disclosed, apart from a portion that don't have an English summary, that's really it in terms of backlog. From then on in, we're going to be disclosing on a weekly or two-weekly basis with a few statements coming in at that time. And so that's where we're moving to, quite an efficient system. And we would be happy to work with the Chamber, work with the Defence, so that whatever we do is not criticised, but understood. As far as delaying the proceedings, Your Honours, I mean, there's about 4,000 civil party applications in this case already. You know, I would ask Your Honours to consider how many of those applications have been put forward to witnesses coming before this court as propositions. And I don't think it's that many. Thank you.
President Judge Lavange, you have the floor.
Judge Lavange, la parole.
Oui, encore une petite question à Monsieur le procureur.
A question I would like to put to the co-prosecutor.
Vous observez que les segments actuels du procès 2-2, en particulier case, le segment concernant Trapintement est particulièrement concerné par la communication de nouveaux documents
sensitive to the forwarding of new documents coming from cases 3 and 4.
Avoir à examiner un certain nombre d'autres segments dans ce dossier
consider a certain number of other segments in cases in case 0202 in particular the treatment of certain specific groups whether it be the CHAM, the Vietnamese,
les anciens fonctionnaires
the former officials of the Khmer Republic or other topics such as S21.
Est-ce que vous pouvez nous dire si cela vous est possible, si vous pensez que s'agissant des autres segments à venir du dossier 2-2,
regarding the other segments,
il est à envisager qu'il y ait la même masse de nouveaux documents soit être communiqués au parti, soit susceptibles de faire l'objet de requêtes
that might be the object
pour être versés au débat comme nouveaux éléments de preuve.
Je crois que c'est important pour nous evidence. Parce que so it's important for us to know this because now we would like to have a more long-term vision.
Ce dossier, ce procès est long
that this is a long trial and that there are several phases that need to be considered.
Thank you, Your Honour. Earlier I offered that maybe that could be done in writing, but I can give you some brief numbers now. Certainly what we can say, from what we know in relation to the civil party applications, the applications are going to diminish quite markedly from the number in Trapang Tamaidam. For example, on Wednesday, and today you'll receive the notice, the defence will receive 31 civil party applications in relation to the CHAM and their corresponding summary. Then, because we needed to obviously get them out sort of immediately, and then from that point forward, in relation to, and this is in relation to case 4, from that point forward, and we would hope
In 2 weeks' time, we will get authorization to release 103 applications relating to the Lon Nol officials, 102 in relation to forced marriage, 60 in relation to Krang Ta Chan, but largely in relation to finding out the identity of people that were in that prison, 47 in relation to the treatment of the Vietnamese and Buddhists, 10 in relation to S21, 6 1st of January Dam, 2 Camp On Chenang, 1 Tram Cop, and there's about 19 others which we're sorting out. But in relation to case file, that was case file 4, in relation to case file 3, 10, in relation to treatment of the CHAM, they will become available at an expedited rate. 72 in relation to Lon Nol, 62 in relation to treatment of Vietnamese, 42 in relation to forced marriage, 14 Krang Ta Chan, 7 1st of January Dam, 1 Camp On Chenang Airport, 13 in relation to S21. Now, some of them are some of those numbers relate to applications that we've reviewed that may have two or more issues in them. So in total, for case file 3, something less than 221 applications being put forward, not as evidence as such, but as in relation to our disclosure obligation, and obviously a far smaller percent in relation to evidence. Case file 4 in total, including Trepang Tamar Dam, 650 applications, but they relate, again, they relate to segments in the future or segments in the past. And as I said to Your Honours, and I understand why you need a clear path, I think everyone does in relation to disclosure, we can't provide complete vision because as Khieu Samphan's counsel has mentioned, although we're involved in the investigations, we don't control the investigation in cases 3 and 4. It's up to the investigative judges on who gets interviewed and when and how much they need. But we believe that with this disclosure over the next couple of days for the immediate segments and for all the other segments within the next couple of weeks, because we need to get that authorization from OCIJ, we believe that the significant backlog, or the backlog in relation to disclosure, has been done from the prosecution. And then we're moving towards this just-in-time system where, and this is where we can agree with the defence, perhaps we can discuss with them, do we disclose to you once a week, or do we disclose to you once every 2 weeks when we get 3 statements or 5 statements? Would you like to wait for another 2 weeks? That's something perhaps as a more of a technical discussion, which we would be interested in the defence's views on how they would like to receive that material. Thank you.
Oui, merci beaucoup, Monsieur le Procureur,
pour ces précisions. Very much for this clarification.
Donner des indications
you have provided
les constitutions
us with information with regard to the civil party applications. Do you have an idea
de la situation qui pourrait concerner des documents autres que les
the situation
civil.
With regard to
Alors,
other documents other than the civil party applications? I know it's a bit complex that the investigation is in the process and there might be other witnesses who are still being heard or who are going to be heard. I don't exactly know what the situation is, but you already, as of today, do you have an idea
pour ces autres catégories de documents
the situation with, concerning the other documents aside from the civil party application?
We can give you some information, Your Honours, in relation to that. Firstly, I'd like to say, with just to finish off on civil party applications, in relation to that, on case file 4, there are about 720 civil party applications. On case file 3, there are about on case file 3, there's about 487 civil party applications, somewhat smaller. In relation to case file 3, by and large, we've got a summary of translation of them, and obviously this disclosure is done on that basis. And
And for case file 4, we have summary translations in the main, but a smaller number of full translations of 1,200 of them. So those other 500, of course, we need to get from the VSS unit, we need to get those summary translations, if any further needs to be disclosing, but then that's it. As Mr. Lysak said the other week, we've obviously, for perhaps obvious reasons, we've prioritized the review of written records of interview. And as of last Monday, give or take a document, but this is the position. As of last Monday, the 3rd of August, the prosecution has got its documents that it's received off its desk, and we have 70 written records of interview awaiting authority from the OCIJ to disclose. We've requested them, and we're waiting for authority to do that. What we have found, Your Honours, is that there's a far more reactivity with us and the Office of Investigative Judges now. They very much understand the urgency of making sure there's no build-up or backlog. And so we're getting a very short turnaround. I think last week we had a turnaround of 4 or 5 days to get those applications approved. We hope to build on those relationships to keep that going for the obvious reasons raised by the defence. In terms of what those, sorry, it's 67 written records outstanding with OCIJ, 12 relate to the CHAM, 14 relate to Vietnamese, 30 relate to Khmer Republic officials, 7 relate to the Vietnamese issue, and we have another 23 that relate to forced marriage, 1 1st of January dam, and 1 for Tram Cop. So once we get authority to disclose, and we'll be working hard this week to ask the investigative judges to release that material, then our desk is clear in terms of written records of interview. And you know, in terms of contemporaneous documents, large numbers of those contemporaneous documents on 3 and 4 are very similar, if not the same as contemporaneous documents in case file this trial. So the one thing we can say, Your Honour, is those cases are massive, and we have basically employing someone full-time to coordinate disclosure. The whole office has to be involved, and we would appreciate any collaborative efforts with the defence for future disclosure to work out the best and the most effective way to get the material to them, whether they would like it every 2 weeks or every week, what would be useful for them. Thank you.
Mr. President.
Something look me to be.
President, yes, Councillor Copper, do you have the floor?
Thank you. I have a, if you will allow me, a question to the prosecution. I understand that there's a change in policy in terms of which civil party applications should be put before the chamber as evidence, but I presume that that's not the same situation with WRIs. I think it would be fair to assume that all of those 70 or so WRIs will be put forward to the chamber as evidence, or is that not the case? I would like, if possible, an answer to that question.
No, that would not. Yeah, that would not be the case. The policy in relation to indicating which written records of interview we would be putting forward in relation to 87.4, that would be indicate that in our motion to disclose to the chamber. So. Not every written record of interview
that we would disclose to this trial chamber, would we necessarily be asking for a Rule 87.4 application? And I think we would indicate that. Well, we would make best efforts to indicate that when those written records of interview have been disclosed. But the answer is yes, we would be applying a similar policy to written records of interview, but I think it's highly likely that probably more of them would be subject of Rule 87.4 applications for perhaps reasons which people may understand.
Pour des raisons que tout le monde comprendra.
President, Defense Counsel of Khe Sampon, you have the floor.
La défense de Khe Sampon, la parole.
Consum-on, thank you, Mr. President. I'd like to make my observation regarding the debate this morning on the issue of the disclosure.
Ce matin qui porte sur la question des communications.
As a matter of principle, this will have an impact on my defense of my client's Khe Sampon.
C'est une question de principe.
That is based on this continuing disclosure, and we are not in any clear position to know when it's going to end. And that is confirmed by the international deputy co-prosecutor in his response to Judge Lavergne's request.
International en réponse à la demande du juge
Lavergne. The documents that we received from the proceedings of investigations by the international co-investigating judge
procédure d'instruction
is not actually a complete set of documents conducted by the entire OCIJ. We all know that there are two investigative teams exist within the OCIJ, and we also see the disagreement in cases 003 and 004 by OCIJ investigating judges, and the disclosure by the OCP falls into a similar fashion, as the disclosure is initiated only by the international co-prosecutor and not at the initiation by the entire representation of the OCP.
Mais pas par tous les coprocureurs.
Thus, it is clear that we can see a pattern of disagreement
donc on voit bien qu'il existe
in the investigative
des désaccords
process in cases 003 and 004, and as a result, some of those documents are part of the disclosure for case 002.
Des documents communiqués, transmis au
dossier 002. I have heard the deputy co-prosecutors on the issue of those disclosures that they will disclose all kinds of documents, whether they are
bon nombre de documents seront communiqués
and the benefit of the defense.
Soient à charge
however, from what we can see, they are all inculpatory evidence so far.
Nous avons pu voir jusqu'à présent, les documents qui ont été communiqués sont tous
and this
à charge.
Is an illustrative of a
voilà
negative point in terms of the
négatif.
Defending to the rights of my client's Khe Sampon according to the applicable law and procedures.
Met en péril la défense de mon client en vertu
it is therefore my humble request to the chamber that the chamber shall determine a deadline for the disclosure of documents related, initiated rather by the international co-prosecutor from cases 3 and 4. This will minimize its impact on the defense of my clients, Khe Sampon. In addition, it will avoid the complexity of dealing with the continuing disclosure of documents by the international co-prosecutor.
De la gestion de ce type de communication.
The disclosure is within the limit of the co-prosecutors, but it does not apply to the client. That is my client. Thank you.
The chamber will adjourn
this morning proceedings now, and we will resume this afternoon at 1:30. And at that time, we will hear testimony of a witness to TCW 881. And this information is for all concerned parties and the general public. Security personnel just started to take a kill some Paul to the waiting room downstairs and have him returned to attend the proceedings this afternoon before 1:30. The court is now in recess.
Veuillez vous lever.